I'm Court. I'm one of the owners of Ecuador Freedom Bike Rental. We've been really looking forward to this ride. It's a combination of some of the best routes that we take, and we're going to go to some very interesting places, very far out in the middle of nowhere.
Good morning, I'm Sylvain, co-owner of Ecuador Freedom with Court. And this is Diego, our mechanic. He's one of the best mechanics in Ecuador. He's the best mechanic in Ecuador.
So Sylvain and I have been running this company for 4 years. Like I said, this is a combination of some of the best things we see in Ecuador. We can't see everything we love in Ecuador in 10 days, but this gets close to that. It's a lot of different cultures, a lot of different terrains and climates we'll be passing through. We got a great group. I'm very excited about this. Very good people along with us on this ride.
My name is George Revington. So I live in Greensboro, North Carolina. Packing is part of the fun. It's the anticipation and the thought. So
yeah, absolutely.
I like to just be out there. I like to be on the bike and I like to ride. I just like to ride.
Eric Reutemann. I'm living near Chicago, Schaumburg, Illinois, but originally from Switzerland. I saw in the internet when he was, they were checking out this route over the Amazonas River. I said, oh, that sounds interesting. And then when they said they were going to do this trip, I signed up. I didn't want to miss it. So.
Jim Moss, and I'm from all over, kind of. I grew up in Colorado. I've lived in about 5 or 6 different states, and I have a house now along the Blue Ridge in near Roanoke, Virginia.
What do you reckon you're looking forward to most about this tour?
Riding. everything. It's just a neat looking country.
Yeah, absolutely.
Everything I can see is just fantastic.
Yeah.
You know, so, awesome.
My name is Vania, and I am from Greece, living in New York.
Yes.
I found out about Ecuador Freedom Bikers looking online. I was trying to look for somebody, for a company that I can trust, a company that will help me in this sort of adventure.
What are you looking forward to the most?
Go to places where not many people go and seeing cultures that are not so visible to the outside world, and nature places that are not so visible to the outside world.
I'm Tom Hassel. I'm a retired dentist from North Carolina. Did a lot of homework, Chile, Peru, Patagonia, all over, and I thought the best overall offer and experience was through this company, and we decided to do it, and it wasn't a mistake. It was just exactly what we were looking for. The second one will be interesting because of putting the motorcycles on a canoe, going 100 miles up river, then unloading the bikes and riding back down in the jungle. That'll be a good experience as well. So we've got a lot of excitement ahead of us.
I'm Dennis Yeomans. I live in Hawaii. This is my second trip with Court and Sylvan on this. Tom and I had such a great time last time. We're welcome to come back and see a little new portion of Ecuador.
Yeah.
The canoe trip will be new, and I've never been in the Amazon at all, so I'll be very interested in the flora and fauna of the Amazon, and the fish and the, everything. That'll be interesting.
Yeah, for sure.
My name's Adam Cooper. I'm from Tasmania, Australia, and this is my second time to Ecuador. So we're here. We're going to be documenting the trip, and we've brought along with us a little drone, so we're pretty excited about that. We're going to get some aerial footage of the tour, which I think has never been done before, in this country at least. So that's one thing that we're really looking forward to, and being able to show exactly where you ride from a bird's eye view. So it should be really, really cool. Looking forward to it.
My name's Rebecca Lowers, and I'm from Canada. I'm here to go biking for 10 days with Ecuador Freedom Bike Rental. And I'll be doing some filming for High View Productions and soaking up the experience.
Everything that's alive goes flying in seeds. Garden, how they grow into nice red blooms.
Challenge you on the gravel. It's that gravel is the only way to get to these far out places.
Yes.
But there's a certain pleasure and thrill about riding on gravel and going fast, and you're always kind of slipping a little bit.
It's going good.
Okay.
We just went through some rain and it was tough. Should be good. We just went through the hardest part of the ride, I think. The rest is gonna be beautiful.
Beautiful roads and beautiful scenery.
Yeah.
Even though it was wet and misty and low clouds at times, it was just beautiful ride. Beautiful ride.
It was a perfect day in adventure riding.
Aqua tiente. That's how good the day was.
Night.